forth. Please begin. We will start with the Pledge of Allegiance and a moment of silence, Frank. Would you please, please?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. Item two is public participation. Is there anyone from the public wishing to speak at this time? Seeing none, we'll close and move on to approval of prior minutes. Now, I know we did have some corrections that some of the members had sent in. If you guys still need more time to make sure the minutes are accurate, we could always table these till the next meeting. I know Judy did not do the correct
Table the budget deliberation minutes?
Okay, the March 13th budget deliberation minutes, those are the ones that had the most questions. Any of the others? Could I have a motion for the rest of them?
So moved.
Second.
You're going to do them all at once? Then I'll abstain on the ones that I wasn't at.
I think that you can vote on them. It's the appropriateness of, Randy, can you vote on them if you weren't here? You don't have to abstain?
You can, but it's...
Yeah, you can, but the question is whether or not he has a level of information that allows him to vote on that, so it's his call.
Right.
And I abstain from those which I was not present.
Do you know which ones those were, or would you like us to check?
No, my name is on the minutes. It's all in the record.
Okay.
But for the record, I'm abstaining for those meetings in which I was not present.
Thank you, Frank.
For the record, I too will abstain for the meeting that I was not at.
Make an amendment, if I could, to the motion for the 2/26/14 minutes.
Yep.
On page 18, Carl DeMille is incorrectly identified as Carl Dunham.
Correct.
Make that change.
Every single time Carl spoke, he was identified as Carl Dunham. So it's called me. Walter?
I do not read every word, but let me tell you, I was rather impressed with this tone of budget hearing meetings and deliberation. I just want to, for the record, hats off to the recording secretaries, who I thought performed a rather Herculean task in putting this together, and if it's appropriate, from the town council through the mayor's office, I would like a letter of appreciation to go to the ladies. I thought they did a terrific job.
Well, let's take that and consider it after we're right here in the middle of this. So
great.
Consider that right after.
Sure.
So
we have a long way to go for a paperless.
So the motion is the amendment to the February 26, 2014, correcting a name that's incorrect, and also excluding Beth, Katie, and Frank to abstain from the meetings they were not present.
I just put me down there.
And Mary Jane. If they weren't there, they're abstaining.
Are you going to have one?
All in favor of the meeting minutes for the meetings they attended?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? And then we will table the budget deliberation minutes for the next meeting because there were quite a few things that were left out. Good? All right, and then also a letter of appreciation. I don't need a vote for that, Walter. I'll just...
Great. Terrific.
For the secretaries. Thank you. That's very nice of you.
Welcome.
Next are the appointments or reappointments. Pete?
They are, like the council's approval for the local emergency planning committee, Carl Pooch, the Gaylordsville Fire Department, replacing Lee Hendricks. Term 3/24/2014 to 11/30/2014.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained?
Reappointment to Commission of the Arts, Sarah C. Adams, 12/01/2013 to 11/30/2016.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstain?
For the Economic Development Commission, Angela Chastain, 12/01/2013 to 11/30/2018.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstain?
Inland Wetlands Commission, the alternate, Angela Dimin, 12/01/2012 to 11/30/2016.
Second. Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstain?
Lanesville Fire Substation Trustees, Frederick C. Aldrich, 12/01/2013 to 11/30/2016.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstain?
Municipal Citation Hearing Officer, Ramona Tito, 12/01/2012 to 11/30/2014.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstain?
Pension Committee, Thomas Pilla, George Barnett, Joanne Chapin, all terms 12/01/2013 to 11/30/2015.
Second.
Any discussion?
Yeah, I'm just curious. I was appointed at the last meeting or the meeting before that. Is my term coexisting with these or am I a different term?
I think it does, Frank. I'd have to look it up.
I'm just curious.
Were they the same?
Frank's term is a different term. His seat is current now. So next November, your term would expire.
Okay, but I was reappointed.
Yes.
At the last meeting.
Yes.
Okay, I'm just curious why all of us came through except.
Two seats are offset.
Correct.
And one is vacant.
You will expire, Frank, yes.
We're not in charge of that date.
The term, Walter, the term. The term.
Did we vote? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstain? Just on item five, under Mayor's comments, I wanted you to know that we are having another community panel. Just for your information, a little advance notice, it will be Tuesday, April 1st, with regard to opioid use prevention and intervention resources. It'll be at John Pettibone Elementary School in New Milford. That's Tuesday, April 1st at 7 o'clock. We have had one similar in the past. This will have organizations in the area that address drug misuse issues and rehab. So we have MCCA, Mountainside High Watch Rehab, Department of Mental Health and Addiction Services, drug and alcohol counselors, HVCASA, which is the regional drug interaction resource, New Milford Youth Agency, and New Milford High School, and the health department. So anyone that wants to go, they're going to talk about recognizing or hopefully being able to recognize problems in children and young adults, what drug addiction is, what to do if you think that your family member has a problem. And I think they're going to spend quite some time on prescription drugs and the danger of having them laying around for not just your family, but other people who have children visiting or guests who are visiting. And we're also tonight adding an item to the agenda that actually goes with that. I will when it's all done.
Okay.
This one was the draft I got brought today that I marked up, and as soon as Mark finishes putting that up, I'll have him send it to you.
Awesome.
Not a problem. Along that line, I would like the council to entertain waiving the rules to add the acceptance of a donation to the youth agency to buy that lockbox that they're supposed to be getting for drug drop-off from the New Milford Rotary. And if I could get a motion to waive.
Motion waived.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? So that will be our last item then tonight. Pete?
Yes, Mayor, just want to thank you and your staff for putting this together. I know it's been on the minds of a lot of our citizens here in town, and I just appreciate the proactivity to it. And any education that any parent or child can get with this, you know, this epidemic is, I think, of utmost importance. And just thank you.
Well, thank you, Pete. We appreciate it. Frank?
Yeah, just along the lines you were, it's on your comments, but some of us are aware of the citation that was given to Milford to be the top 100 safest cities in America.
Right.
But not everybody in the public has gotten that. But is there a way that you could do a press release for the mayor's office to go to the paper? They should see the good things that come out too, and not just the things that are bad. And I thought that was exceptional. And that's due to our police department and the other service that work in this town. But it is a good place to live, and that article indicates it's one of the best places to live.
Yeah, for communities of 25,000 or greater, top 100. So that was pretty good.
Did you want to go ahead and just do the motion now for the light box, since we're talking about?
Okay, this is to accept the $800 from the New Milford Rotary. It's to put a box in the police department for unused prescription painkillers or any other drugs, which keeps them out of other people's hands and also keeps them out of our waterways, because that's become a health hazard. Good motion.
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained?
Mike, could we send could we send a letter to the Rotary and thank them?
You can just thank us.
Thanks.
Thanks, guys.
I'm sure Tom would like to get it and read it.
It would be appreciated.
Yeah. I have a letter for all of you to read it at the donation. Okay. No other comments there. If we can have item six is an executive session with an update, a continued update on the Ask Me Local 1303-183 contract negotiations, inviting in Ken Taylor and Al Chapin and Randy DeBell. Everything out. We're back from executive session, and no motions were made and no votes were taken. And we're moving to item seven, which is Public Works and a request to authorize, which is the same format that the Board of Ed uses, by the way, when we're talking about the capital reserve money. Mike is here to talk about these roads, which used to be in the budget. These are reconstruction projects, and that they were not. Pete?
I'd like to make a motion to authorize the expenditure of up to $585,000 for the capital reserve fund for the reconstruction paving of three roads presented in the 2014-15 Public Works Department budget, with the approximate distribution of costs as follows: Meeting House Terrace, $300,000, Norton Lane, $40,000, Meadowland Drive,
$245,000.
Okay.
So
hi,
there you go.
Can I? Good evening.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Good night. Good night, Rishi.
I just put a board up just for locations of the three roads, but basically just up off of West Meeting House Road, Meeting House Terrace and North Lane. They're the two right in the middle of the map, just above the middle of the map there. And then Meadowland Drive is up in the Gables Hill section, up off of South Pembroke. So they're, you know, more residential type subdivisions, and what we're trying to do is focus on operating budgets. You know, this discussions in the budget process, if you recall. With the audit that came back, we asked that those roads be taken out of the operating budget and then get funded through the authorization of the capital reserve. So we're here to ask for that appropriation authorization. I guess it's maybe the right term to spend those funds out of that account.
Thank you. Frank?
I'm just curious. Meeting downstairs, I know that is Meadowland Drive and Norton Lane, you said they were in residential. How old are they?
Is Norton off of Meeting House Terrace?
Yes, Norton Lane is off of Meeting House Terrace, correct. It was built more recent, at least parts of it were built more recent than that.
Norton is newer, I think. It's the spur off of.
Correct.
Well, if it's a newer road, then my question is, why we...
Not newer, it's 40.
It's still aged. I think there was one section that was built along with Meeting House Terrace, and then it was extended several years later. Its rating is better in terms of an overall condition rating. It's at 51, but for ease of reconstruction, we didn't find the point of not reconstructing a fairly small length of road that is in that shape.
And to Frank's question, up on Meadowland and Gaylor's Road, these are the roads that you were discussing making a little bit narrower than the 24 feet?
Correct.
Because it would cost less and still service the neighborhoods?
Yes.
I was trying to figure out where they fit. I know you have your rating systems for the roads.
Yes.
Are there any other roads that are kind of nearing the same point that we're going to have to start thinking about very soon?
There's plenty of other roads. Like I said, we're kind of making sure that we're dedicating some funds to reconstructing, because these are the kind of roads that, unfortunately, when you start prioritizing a list of 485 different segments of road, typically are not going to rank. The OCI ratings are going to rank along with several other ones, but when you start prioritizing, how do you prioritize 50 roads that are similar condition? You're going to go based on, traffic condition it's serving, neighborhood traffic and other parameters like that, that unfortunately some of the smaller dead-end roads aren't going to really see the priority. So we've been trying to dedicate a portion of our budget to going towards just, making sure that we're addressing some of those roads each year as well. That's why we kind of keep it in the operating budget, normally is our request, and the other one is going to come out of maybe other bond funds or other larger reserve funds that that can pay for a Long Mountain and a Mariel Road and those kinds of roads.
Okay.
Does that answer your question?
It does.
So, okay.
But this is kind of a broader scale than just this. I know this winter was horrific for the roads, and you guys started doing the assessments on all the roads.
We will be back out reassessing all of the roads based on our five-year capital plan anyways, to see where they rank, because obviously this is based on last year's ratings. But we do go out and reassess those roads in the springtime to make sure that any other things that have to get done to them get done prior to us going through whatever the roadmap plan is on those roads.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Walter.
And all the paperwork I've taken a look at, I probably missed the number. What is in the capital reserve? How much money do we have there?
For the town, you have, let's see, hang on, let me do it quick. About a little over 900,000 on the town side of the capital reserve, not counting the BOE.
Is this doable from the capital reserve 585?
Out of the 909, yeah.
What designates that, the difference between that and the capital reserve and the surplus?
The town council put it there.
Out of the surplus.
Out of surplus monies
we're doing it. Not a bad idea.
You weren't here.
We actually did it.
I missed that meeting.
We actually did it because the bond council preferred us to do that. To strengthen the sports and whatever
was to create that capital account for projects that were in, like these are out of the 5-year capital plan.
Let's say the undesignated fund is how big
is it? Undesignated fund is almost 13 million. Other discussion? Sorry, I didn't see it, Kate.
What exactly are you going to do to the Little Norton Lane? What kind of repair? Just curious. Do you resurface it?
Yeah, we're going to reclaim it first. We'll test the gravels and see if we need to add additional gravel to it. I'm sure will be some drainage fixes, although, you know, parts of the system, like I said, are newer, so we may not do quite as much in certain parts of the drainage system there. Probably a little different on Neenah's Terrace and Nettoland that are a little older. So all of that gets assessed, and as we're, you know, have to road that up, and then we'll, of course, repave the road in as a final process.
How long, Neenah's Terrace, I know it's got a lot of problems, but how long a stretch of it are you going to do work on? No, Neenah's Terrace.
Yes, Neenah's Terrace. It's a loop, basically, right? A little over half mile, if I'm not mistaken.
Thanks.
Just under half mile, 0.46.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? Thank you very much.
Thanks, Mike.
Okay, item 8A is the yearly State Homeland Security Grant Program.
I hereby move that we approve the following resolution authorizing the mayor to sign the FY 2013 State Homeland Security Grant Program as follows. Resolved that the town of Milford may enter into, with, and deliver to the state of Connecticut Department of Emergency Services and Public Protection, formerly the Department of Emergency Management and Homeland Security, any and all documents which it deems to be necessary or appropriate, and further resolve that Patricia Murphy, as the mayor of the town of Milford, is authorized and directed to execute and deliver any and all documents on behalf of the town of Milford, and to do so and perform all acts and things which she deems to be necessary or appropriate to carry out the terms of such documents, including but not limited to executing and delivering all agreements and documents contemplated by such documents. I didn't add the he, she in there. Is that a...
That's fine. The state will, I think they'll go with that.
Was there a second?
Second.
And the budget for this, is, which is all regional, by the way, all the towns in Dennis regions five, participate in this program, and this is all just the grant program and how they allocate all their reserves. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? Thank you very much. Okay, 8B is a little bit mixed. 8B has some good news, some interesting news, some surprising news, and some news got out ahead of us. In your packet is the paperwork that was prepared last week with our continuing application with the Department of Economic and Community Development. If you open it up in here, it outlines the funds that the DECD and our office thought would be appropriate with regard to the reclamation, demolition, and final remediation for the Century Grass project. Now, these numbers are from 2 or 3 months ago with DECD. The governor's announcement has different numbers, but I think what he, I don't know what numbers, where he got the numbers on the one front, but the rest is all good. So what happened is, this grant is an Urban Act grant, and it comes from the Economic and Community Development Office. What the governor's announcement was that he's going to include this topic for $2.5 million grant on his bond council agenda this coming Friday. which would fund this project to the Department of Economic and Community Development, who we will be getting the grant from. So the paperwork that the Economic and Community Development Office got, and Susan, I'll give you a copy. The paperwork that the Economic and Community Development Office sent me are the numbers that we've been working with for the last several months. And you'll see on page 3.
5 has been the number all along, right?
As their grant with a $500,000 from the town of New Milford. Now, there's a couple of different sources of funds for that we're reviewing. If you recall, the Boardman Road project had some money left over, so we're going to request from our own bond council, since it's on the same road and we did do infrastructure upgrades there, can we also use the leftover funds from that project for this? And at the same time, we've prepared a letter to go to the DECD to remind them that on their end, the match that went to that Boardman Road project, they have money left over too, so would they consider applying that to this also? Walter?
Where does the $3,300,000, where does the other $300,000 come from then?
Yeah,
it says the center.
Project description's got 3.3.
I think that they're talking about.
It says the total cost is $3,300,000.
Construction and legal. I think they're talking that $3 million is the project, and they're taking out. I don't know where they got the 300, unless they're considering their 290 that they have in hand. The other end of the Boardman Road.
Well, we're going to get 2.5.
We're getting 2.5,
and that's 3. But the
3 million is the source of funds that I'm working with, and I'm thinking that that's. It could be a typo.
That's what I'm
typo.
So it's the only place that it's shown.
Because these are the numbers that we've been working with.
So it'd be 500
and it's
from us.
Okay.
And I can easily find that out anyway, because I had them fix 320,000 because they had the building listed as 32,000 square feet. And I called them up and said, no, that's 320,000.
It's just a little bigger. It's on the point center. It's on the point center.
You can almost get 3 cars in there.
And if you also, Mayor, it'll be in the newest press piece. Yes, that's wrong. That's the one I'm telling you.
The 3.7, so there's errors.
I have no idea what the 7 is from.
Okay.
Sounds good.
And where was I walking? I was trying to give you the background on the thing. Oh, okay. So, you want me to just stop talking and you can ask questions?
I just made the point that this money that they're talking about, the money is real, but the estimates are estimates.
Yes.
It hasn't gone out to bid, so we really don't know what the hard number is. But my guess is that it'll probably come in low, so there might not be any money to have to make up.
Tom, I don't know if you were ahead of Joe or...
Who's doing the motion?
You want me to?
I'm going to do it if we can. You have to take a discussion of possible action. We need to read the whole thing.
There's a.
We need to read the entire resolution.
1-3.
Andy, you need.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no. You don't have to read the entire resolution.
Be it resolved, this 1-3 section?
Sure. Did you see this?
Because Randy reviewed the entire packet.
From the governor, too.
But I'd like to make a motion on discussion of possible action on the attached resolution authorizing Mayor Patricia Murphy.
Yeah, you better read.
The town of New Milford. Make application to the Department of Economic and Community Development, DECD, pursuant to CGS Section 44-66C, Urban Act, in the amount of $2,500,000 in order to undertake the Century Brass Center demolition project.
And to execute. And now, does he have to read the whole rest of it?
You can adopt it.
Yes.
As stated.
Okay.
Or you can read the entire thing. But I would poll each individual member of the town council to see if they've read this. And then you can adopt it. So the state knows that it's been actually read by the town council and adopted as written.
Randy, your pleasure. Would you rather it be for you? For
My well, you know, you know me. My preference would be that you read it.
I can mark this thing. I go to
town. There you go.
You ask
Now do I need to read the first section again?
No, you do not.
Now therefore, be resolved by the town of, by the...
No.
I just read that.
He read that.
Now therefore, be it resolved by the New Milford Town Council that it is cognizant of the conditions and prerequisites for state financial assistance imposed by CGS Section 4-66C Urban Act. Number two, that filing on the application for the state financial assistance by the town of New Milford in the amount not to exceed $2,500,000 is hereby approved, and that Patricia Murphy, Mayor, is directed to execute and file such application with the Connecticut Department of Economic and Community Development to provide such additional information to execute such other documents as may be required to execute an assistance agreement with the state of Connecticut for financial assistance if such an agreement is offered, to execute any amendments, decisions, and revisions thereto, and to act as the authorized representative of the town of New Milford. Number three, that it adopts or has adopted as its policy to support the following non-discrimination agreements and warranties provided in subsection A1 of the Connecticut General Statute, section 4A-60 and 4A-60A, respectfully, as amended by Public Acts 07-142 and 07-245, and for which purpose the contractor is the town of New Milford, and contract is said assistance agreement. The contractor agrees and warrants that the performance of the contract, such a contractor will not discriminate or permit discrimination against any person or group of persons on the grounds of race, color, religious creed, age, marital status, national origin, ancestry, sex, mental retardation, or physical disability, including but not limited to blindness, unless it is shown by such contractor that such disability prevents performance of the work involved in any manner prohibited by the laws of the United States or the State of Connecticut. The contractor further agrees to take affirmative action to ensure that applicants with job-related qualifications are employed, and that the employees are treated when employed without regard to their race, color, religious creed, age, marital status, national origin, ancestry, sex, mental retardation, and physical disability, including but not limited to blindness, unless it is shown by contractor as such disability prevents performance of work involved. The contractor agrees and warrants that in the performance of the contract, such contractor will not discriminate or permit discrimination against any person or group of persons on grounds of sexual orientation in any manner prohibited by the laws of the United States or the State of Connecticut, and that employees are treated when employed without regard to their sexual orientation.
So it's
second.
That was excellent. Michael, yes, I bet that's
special education for you.
Is that public school?
Paid attention in third grade.
Yeah.
Inside, we have the original Catherine Smith, the DECD commissioner, did recommend this to the governor. As you can imagine, Senator Chapin has been diligently working on this with the governor's office. So there's a nice note there for the bipartisan working relationship up there, which I think will benefit all of us here in New Milford. And we actually had the congresswoman and the previous food commissioner out to the site. We had Maggie McCleary, the DECD assistant commissioner, out to the site. We have put in a lot of work on this particular grant, and we also needed to come up with a plan for the DECD, not that it was written in stone, but to give them an idea that we're not just developing a piece of property to be a strip mall or something like that, that it really was a plan that the town could be flexible with and develop good jobs or other uses. So if we have the map here, if you all recall, I have this map in my office, which is, you know, kind of like that, wait, every day, there it is. It still shows the wastewater treatment facility, which, as you know, the town has cleaned up and taken care of, those holding ponds with all the runoff and junk from the metal environment, all those pits, and then all the land was all cleaned, and then the inside floor was cleaned, and then, of course, we have that problem with the roof with the friable asbestos in it. So you're looking at this building, almost 8 acres. And so the plan I set up was kind of a mixture of a lot of things that the people in this room have said they'd like to see up there, figuring that if this variety of people like it, then the variety of people at the state might like it. So since we have that railroad there, we put a few of the buildings here for businesses, because as you know, the size properties available that are most in demand in New Milford that we have the least of are that next step up out of those people that have businesses that are growing in their industrial condos. So they buy one or two or three condos, and now they need parking and everything. And we just don't have those 1, 2, 3 acre right. sites for these businesses in that next right. step. So we put a few here. Renewable energy, this here represents a fuel cell, just as an example of a class one renewable energy source with its little 30-foot backdrop. Not saying it has to be that, but that we've sent in because that also contributes to the points when you're evaluated on your grant application. And then many people have discussed relocating public works, because sometimes we have interest in people that would like to develop down near the river, and they always talk about, well, would you ever want to move public works or anything? So I included that, and then here's the rest of the property. This road is just an alternative for the state and the town to consider, because we're probably never going to be able to raise the train trestle. And so the idea of being able to get trucks or anything higher than, you know, 11 feet or so around the train tracks is always a challenge. So this is a road that goes through the back of the hillside behind the plant, all conceptual, doesn't go near the river or anything, and it comes out south of the ball field, so it wouldn't interfere in the ball field, but it would get around the other side of that big hill and those that the train trestle there that we have to go under that the trucks get stuck in. So that's there just as a conceptual. We're good about the proposed preliminary, which is what the DEC did. I called them up and I said, so how's this plan? Is it flexible? Well, yes, we just want to make sure you're not taking the state economic development money and using it for ball fields or like strip malls. So we'd like to see some substantial something going on. So this is why we sent in. But it's still up to the interpretation of the community and the council and everybody, but they did kind of like it. So, if you had any other questions on that, Scott?
Thank you, Mayor. I love the plan so far. DPW and I have been talking about this for years. But one of the things I wanted to mention, one of the last things I went to with Vin Nolan before he left was a brownfields symposium. And one of the things they did talk about was the way they capped some of the existing cement in areas such as the foundation here and used it as part of the infrastructure. Mm-hmm. And it does look like you've done a little bit of that here. It looks like in some of the parking lots here, like near DPW and in here with some of the roads, and just the reason I mention it is because I know some of that cement, and I think Frank was one of the people that pointed out, is 3 and 4 foot thick up there, isn't it? There's some spots.
Some places, some spots. 6 to 8 feet.
Right.
I mean, the foundations for the draw presses.
Right. And I mean, and as Mike would probably attest, it's a heck of a road base. I don't think that road, you know, if you put a parking lot on top of that or a road on top of that, it's never going anywhere. So I hope in our final design, we try to incorporate as much of that foundation as possible into parking, the road infrastructure, anything that we can, so that we can maybe limit the need to tear all that cement up. At 3 and 4 feet deep, that's a hell of a road base, but I like it. Thank you.
Thank you. Pete?
Thank you, Mayor. First, thank you and your staff for being diligent at getting this grant so that we can finally get the building done. It's been a long time coming, where we can actually get some economic vitality onto that property. I'd also like to thank our former chairman of our Economic Development Commission, Frank, serving with him, and I appreciate his due diligence as well. Just a couple things for housekeeping. One, on page, I guess it's going to, I know they're not numbered, but I guess it's page 3, where its background is at the top. Down at the bottom, there's an asterisk that shows the figures may be amended from time to time through requests for revisions to the project financing plan and budget as approved by the Department of Economic and Community Development. So that may be where the variances are, and just if we could have that in the minutes, that would be great. And then second, I appreciate you going more involved in this preliminary plan to let people know that this isn't set in stone, that it's just a good starting point. And I appreciate you putting all these things in, and looks like a very, very wonderful opportunity for our
you. Mary Jean?
I want to recollect when we had discussions about this years ago. Isn't it in the cement where all the PCBs are in the foundation?
No, but there were some, we had those cleaned up, the floor.
But there was still some left, right?
It was an inch.
There was still.
You could grind the inch or half inch of the top of, right where the transformer sat. They didn't know for sure, because they did borings, thousands of them, on this whole floor. And so that's the one section where they said they would want you to cap it with another pour of something like that if you're going to keep it or tape it. Yeah, there was a lot of, you're right, there's a lot of stuff like that. But we had the floor all cleaned, we had the walls all cleaned, but then the pieces of the chunks of the roof, when they hit the ground, they recontaminate where they sit. So that'll all be, the general plan now, I was talking to Mike and we're contacting the DEEP and the DECD to ask them for examples of the RFPs that they've developed when they've had these projects going on around the state. And anyone that we hire, DECD will have to approve anyway. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to rely on them to help with that. But then there's also these companies that absolutely, that's their expertise. Mm-hmm. That's all they do. So we want to make sure that the remediation is good because we still have to monitor those wells. So that's not anything we wouldn't. So you're right, yeah. And when we get that all new again and fresh, then we'll give you the update on where any of those things were as we recollect, because that's how long now we've been working on that? Years.
9 years.
Yeah.
Frank?
In history, this, the EDC started working on this before the NOAA came in.
Yep.
I remember with Rothschild and myself going up there a lot of times. I think one of the things to keep in mind is this is going to be a bid, mm-hmm. and nobody in his right mind is going to bid on how much PCBs there is there until it's a crapshoot. But I know that we did some extensive digging
yes.
out, and we took the areas we thought were the most effective mm-hmm. and had them dug out 6 feet down.
Yep.
So those areas are okay. So I think the key is going to be the clerk of the works that we have representing the town when they start doing the excavation, and we don't end up with 400 yards of cement that isn't contaminated, but they're going to charge us for contamination. So we have to be really on top of that. So it's going to be a give and take. So in the beginning, we moved on trying to get this building used. I remember sitting on this council with many opportunities to the various people coming in. They want to use it for everything under the sun, none of which was really good for New Milford. So I had to go over, okay, we can't sell the damn thing, so let's take it down. But that was a transition because we really felt that that building had a potential to be a benefit to the town if it was rehab.
But
and it wasn't in the beginning. In the beginning, it could have been rehab, but because it went so long with not being able to be marketed, the roof started caving in, and that was the death knell. My other question is, when you see this proposal, I know there's a permit to extract water from the river and replace it. Now that's a very valuable incentive for this property. I want to know, can it be split, or does it have to be one user? Because one user was Century Brass, was the one who used it. So when we start developing it, can we say take 10,000 gallons for one site and 5,000 gallons for another site?
Well, we would have to read it, but if the town retained the ownership of that, then maybe you develop a site
okay.
without selling it.
But that's important to find out,
yes.
because it is an asset to be able to have water and discharge it back into the river.
Well, you have to have new drains because we poured concrete down the drains that existed. To
well, if you're going to break it up, it's one pipe coming into Century Brass, so you'd have to be able to break it up so it could be extracted from several points.
I meant on the discharge end. For cleanup purposes, we cleaned out water
yeah.
clean and then we capped
yeah.
it. Walter?
Kind of a spin-off of Councilman Esposito, but this presents the community with a wonderful opportunity again. I love the idea, let's move the public works over there. And what an opportunity then to take the waterfront we got along the Housatonic River there, turn it into a walk path, turn it into a bike path, turn it into a picnic area. This wonderful opportunity for the community if this plays out. Great, would be a great scenario for us. And again, part of our future vision for the community, commercial economic development, another attraction for people to come to the community if you have this area where they can watch the birds, take pictures. It's present. Kudos. Thank you.
Thank you, Walter P.
Before we make a note, well, can I talk after a motion?
Sure.
Thank you.
So, as I get updated from DECD and, okay?
Yeah, I have a couple questions. So, they are going to vote, this goes up to the bond commission on Thursday?
Yes.
So what do you think?
The vote will be Friday.
What do you think the timeframe for RFP, that type of thing would be?
Well, the bond commission will vote on Friday, and then they'll send their formal notice over to the Economic Development Commission. But in the meantime, we'll be working with requesting that they transfer those funds from the other project. Don't know if they will or not, but it's the same street and the same thing. And up there then, we have ours we're tracking down. And then if you remember during the audit, I just want to say this before I forget it. During the audit, we had identified accounts that had money in them that hadn't been closed out. Mm-hmm. So I told Greg that as soon as he has a moment, because he really is like up to here with the newness and stuff, let's pull out the ones that we can identify that are languishing for the last 20 years or whatever, and bring them up to the council and maybe reappropriate where they should go, and maybe put them toward this project. These excess monies that are left over from other projects and things that have hung out for years. And go back, now I forgot your question, but I forgot, I didn't want to
stop. An approximation, the time frame of when you would begin the RFP process, and then therefore
probably the next couple of months.
So
drafting that.
So the beginning of the raising process would be ostensibly within 6 months? I mean, is that a possibility? Just to throw something out, I mean, I'm just curious.
Well, I suppose it's a possibility, but I'm looking at, it's not going to be your local small person that gets to vote or bid on this.
Right.
It might be somebody national.
Yeah.
And I don't know what those timelines would be. This is.
But do you have a desired?
I would love to do it as soon as I can.
Optimism.
And if I could get it done in 6 months, I would. And I also don't know. I'm going to lean heavy on the EDC because they've done it. The economic, the DECD
mm-hmm.
at the state level,
right.
And the DEEP. And can I get back to you with an estimate? Like maybe
no,
they
I just
one.
Wondered if you had.
I'd love to get it done before the winter, and then you
yeah.
have the
well, that's what
season
I was
to market it. I think that would be great.
No, I just wondered if in the conversations you had any gauge of what it might be.
I was excited that DECD was considering the grant. I was even more excited when they called and they said, well, the commissioner wants to recommend it. And then the outgoing commissioner, Dan Estee, had recommended it. And I was really excited when my senator said, the governor's office asked me for a quote. So, you know, every few days or so, he'd say, well, I saw Paul Mounds from the governor's office, or I saw so-and-so from the EDC, or, you know, do you have any other information? And I, sure. So, but to hear that it actually was going to be on the agenda, then I went, well, I better wait. And then
the
to have the announcement that it's...
The blog came out this morning.
I know. But I mean, I have to see it in print because
right.
a blog is a blog. But, so I couldn't, I didn't even get to the, I wonder how long it'll take me because I'm just so dang tickled to... $2.5 million, that is giant amount of money. So I was like, I'll tell you what I sent back to the governor's liaison, to the mayor's, I think. Woohoo! Thanks a lot, April. It's April Capone.
It's great. No, it's great. And I think to what Walter said is that that would be the perfect place to start, you know, the bike path extension. And I mean, if things start to be done there, it'll be a great, great thing.
Might be a nice place for concerts. It could be, you know.
And not to jump in, but we toured DPW a couple of years ago, remember, Walter? I don't know how these guys get the trucks in the building. I really don't. There is such, very carefully. There is very little room over there. Remember, you and I were blown away by
a couple of inches.
Right, a couple of inches. They get a monstrous truck through that, through all of those doors. And just to give these guys some room to breathe down there and the equipment to get in safely and to redevelop that site would be enormous. That's for sure.
Thank you, Pete. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstain?
Kind of segueing into that, do you need any action from us tonight as far as allocating the $500,000 from the unassigned?
No, like I said, tonight's agenda item was from last week, doing the paperwork with the economic development. The bonus was the governor actually announcing, so the news, we had a newspaper reporter call me earlier today, and I just had the hardest time getting him to understand it. This was on the agenda as part of the grant application process. The governor's thing, although welcome, is between him and DECD and outside. Any other motion?
Motion to adjourn, Madam Mayor.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstain?
Congratulations.